Greetings. Thank you, Brother Mon Kazban, for your post about Isaiah 29:11 and 12. 29:11 states that learned men can't read the book because it is sealed. 29:12 states that the unlearned man can't read the book. This time the book is not sealed. It is saying that it is no point to show the literate the book that is sealed, as they won't be able to read. 12, it is no use to show the alphabets to those who can't read. These two verses are not the same. Muhammad's name was clearly spelt out in Isaiah 42:1. Your post contains several errors, and I would like to explain the truth to you, brother. First, brother, let us honor God and honor Prophet Isaiah and read this in context from the Word of God. Isaiah 29:1, Woe, O Ariel! Ariel, the city where David once camped. Add year to year, observe your feasts on schedule. First, brother, notice this is a word against a city called Ariel. Ariel, the city where David once camped. Yet I will distress Ariel, and there shall be moaning and lamentation, and she shall be to me like an Ariel. God says he will distress this city, Ariel. Verse 7, And the multitude of all the nations that fight against Ariel, and all that fight against her and her stronghold and distress her, shall be like a dream, a vision in the night. As when a hungry man dreams, and behold, he is eating and awakes, with his hunger not satisfied. Or as when a thirsty man dreams, and behold, he is drinking and awakes faint, with his thirst not quenched. Notice, brother, these are things that are not satisfying. If you drink in your dreams, it does not quench your thirst. If you eat in your dreams, it does not fill your stomach. So shall the multitude of all the nations be that fight against Mount Zion. Please, my Muslim brother, stop and think what this means. All who fight against Israel, brother, will be unsatisfied. This is the context of the verse you think means Muhammad. Astonish yourself and be astonished. Blind yourselves and be blind. Be drunk, but not with wine. Stagger, but not with strong drink. For the Lord has poured out upon you a spirit of deep sleep, and has closed your eyes, the prophets, and covered your heads, the seers. And now we get to the first verse which Islam allows you to read, brother. And the vision of all this has become to you like the words of a book that is sealed. You have to look, brother, and see that it says a book that is sealed. The rest of this passage is about the same book. The same sealed book. When men give it to one who can read, saying, read this, he says, I cannot, for it is sealed. Give it. The book that is sealed, brother. When men give it to one who can read, saying, read this, he says, I cannot, for it is sealed. Notice who gives the book, brother. When men give it. Men give the book, not an angel. And when they give the book to one who cannot read, saying, read this, he says, I cannot read. Brother, when it says they give the book, it means the same men giving the same book, the same sealed book. You do not get to make up changes to the Word of God. You do not get to change a sealed book to unsealed. You do not get to declare an unnamed man a prophet. You do not get to divide the Word of God that appears together and say they are not related. Before we move on, brother, we must examine Islam's motive for this provably false claim Islam has taught. Surah 7:157, who acknowledge the mission of our messenger, the unlettered prophet, whom they find well described in their Al-Tarwah, or Torah, and Al-Injil, or Gospel. The Quran claims Muhammad is described. No, well described in the Torah and New Testament. And how is Muhammad described in the Quran? Unlettered prophet who cannot read nor write. Is the word prophet mentioned about the man who cannot read? No, the word prophet is not applied to this man who cannot read. And when they give the book to one who cannot read, saying, "Read this," he says, "I cannot read." No, brother, no mention that this man is a prophet. So this does not fit the description the Quran says you will find. Does this verse say the man cannot write? No. The other problem for Islam is that the fable Islam tells is that an angel gives Muhammad the Quran. Does this verse say an angel, or more specifically, Angel Jibril gives this book to the man? No, brother. This verse says, when they. The word they refers back to the same men of the previous verse. It also says the book, and not another book, or an unsealed book. So if you allow God to open your eyes, brother, you will see this verse says, the sealed book is given by men. Isaiah 29:12 does not speak of Muhammad or a prophet, brother. Isaiah 29:12 does not say, an angel gave an unsealed book to Muhammad. And then you claim the following. Muhammad's name was clearly spelt out in Isaiah 42:1. Let's show Isaiah 42:1 and see if your claim is true, brother. Behold, my servant whom I uphold, my chosen one in whom my soul delights. I have put my spirit upon him. He will bring forth justice to the nations. You claim Muhammad's name was clearly spelt out in Isaiah 42:1. Isaiah 42:1, behold my servant whom I uphold, my chosen one in whom my soul delights, I have put my spirit upon him, he will bring forth justice to the nations. Where, brother, where is the name Muhammad? My chosen one in whom my soul delights, I have put my spirit upon him. Isaiah 42 speaks of the Messiah, brother. Both Jews and Christians agree on this. Does Islam teach you Muhammad is the Messiah, brother? Or does it teach Jesus is the Messiah? Clearly this verse, Isaiah 42:1, speaks of Jesus. Brother, the meaning of Isaiah 29, the whole chapter, is well understood. Isaiah 29 is not a prophecy of a prophet who cannot read and cannot write. Isaiah 29 is a message by Prophet Isaiah against Ariel and a people with no vision. Isaiah 29:13, and the Lord said, because this people draw near with their mouth and honor me with their lips. This is the very next verse, brother, that you claim reveals Muhammad. Would you think this speaks of Muslims, brother? Draw near with their mouth and honor me with their lips? Do you draw near to Allah with your mouth and honor him with your lips? Do you think this verse that follows the verse about Muhammad speaks of Muslims? If it does, what else does Prophet Isaiah say of you then, brother? While their hearts are far from me, and their fear of me is a commandment taught by men. Isaiah says your heart is far from God, brother, and you fear God for the wrong reason. You should honor and respect and fear God, brother, because He is God. Because Prophet David has said, "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge." Fear Him because you, in your heart, yearn and long to worship Him and submit to Him. Brother, I have showed you Isaiah 42:1 does not name Muhammad. Whoever told you this was so, told you a falsehood, a lie, brother. I have showed you that you did not know what Isaiah 29:12 said. And from this, it is clear whoever told you it spoke of Muhammad, told you a falsehood, a lie, brother. There is no mention of Muhammad anywhere in the Bible. The claim of Surah 7, 157 and 158 is an unsupportable claim, brother. If you cannot prove it true, you must consider it a lie, brother. I challenge you to think honestly. If Surah 7, 157 and 158 were true, it could be proven true. If Surah 7, 157 through 158 is a lie, so is the whole Quran. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.